गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। यस मैम, आई एम ऑडिबल।
यस सर, यू आर।
या ओके। सो लास्ट क्लास वी आर डन वी थॉट लास्ट बिफोर क्लास प्लॉट्स वी आर डन। Okay, colors were pending. I said in today's lab we'll be discussing about colors. Okay. Okay, see the difference. I have taken a vector 5, 7, 6, 4, 8, and then I draw a bar plot. Okay, I have not mentioned any colors. I have just given the data here. That is nothing but my temp, and then the main heading by default. So when I don't pass any colors, these are the colors. Okay, by default, gray color. Okay, gray color it has got. But if you want to have some customized color, you can use it. Okay, using what? COL. Already I have seen COL stands for color. I said in color I want what? Coral color. Okay, this is a coral color. This is with my coloring. Okay, which color is better? Which graph is better? This plot is better because it is a bit colorful. Okay, here you can replace that with any other color like green, blue, violet, etc. Likewise, there are total 657 colors which are supported by my R programming. How many colors? There are total 657 colors. Only to know that, just run this command color off. If you run this command color off, it will give you the list of all the 657 colors which are supported by our R programming languages using their names. Okay, like LO4, LO3. Likewise, using this name, you just replace in color, you will get those color. This is one way of getting the colors. Okay, there is one more way of getting the colors, that is using their hexa values. Okay, using their hexa values, we can also get that colors. See here, for example, this one. If I give this C000, I will get this color. And for AA4371, I get this color. Okay. So this is one more way of getting the colors. Okay, that is using hexa values. And there is even one more way of getting the colors, that is using RGB values. What does RGB stand for? R means red, green, and blue. Here, what does this mean? RGB of 0, 1, 0 means I don't want red, I don't want blue, I only want green. So this will give me green color. Not only like that, you can give how much ratio you want. I want 0.3 ratio of red, 0.7 ratio of green, and 0.8 ratio of blue, even though you will get that. If you observe here, for these values, red value is 0.3, green value is 0.5, and blue value is 0.2. It is clear that green value we have given more percentage, okay, more value. So it is more like a greenish. And observe here, for red we are given 58, for green 87, and for blue it is 149. Okay, so major is blue. So here in the graph you can see blue being more dominant. Okay, this is third way of colors. Okay, there is one more thing, that is nothing but color cycling. Suppose I have 5 bars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bars. And if I give 5 different colors, you will get 5 different colors for 5 different bars here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For 5 different colors, I am getting 1, 2, 3, 5 different bars. Suppose I have 5 bars, but I have given only 3 colors. I have 5 bars, but I have given only 3 colors. Then what will happen? Those 3 colors will repeat. See here, pink, blue, and green. I have only three different colors, but still have two more bars. That cycle will repeat. So again, you get pink, blue. If there was one more bar, you get it green. So this is how the repetition happens when you give less number of colors compared to the number of bars. Okay. But see here, knowing these hexadecimal values and giving numbers and making a proper combination, it's very difficult. Okay. To make our job easy, there is a concept known as color palette. There is a concept known as color palette. What is color palette? In color palette, there are five built-in color palettes. Okay. There are five built-in color palettes. What are them? Rainbow is one, heat colors, terrain colors, topo colors, and CM colors. So there are five set of palettes in which colors are predefined. Means few set of colors are kept in rainbow, few set of colors are kept in heat color dot colors, few set of colors are there in terrain color, likewise in topo colors and CM colors. So if you give rainbow of five, so it gives you the hexa values which are the colors present in rainbow five. Likewise, you can give rainbow 6, 7, whatever may be. Okay, so we will see the output what it look like. Suppose I give rainbow of five, heat of five, terrain color of five, and topo color of five. So these are the colors which I get. Okay, see here. In previous case, here I need to mention all the five colors, or even in this case, I need to mention all the three colors. But here, no need to mention. You just call the default color palette. What is that? If I call the color rainbow color palette and call five color, these are the five colors which I get. Okay, if I call heat dot colors five, so these are the colors I get from what? Heat palette. Then from terrain palette, I get these colors. So now based on your choice, you can select water palette you want. So this is for topo. Okay, these are the four. Likewise topo, we also have what? CM colors. You can explore it. Now based on your liking, you can select any one of the palette, or you can select different palettes for different graphs. It's up to you. Is this clear, ma? What is your color palettes? Clear up to your color palettes? Now here, we already discussed what is colors and what is RGB. Okay, then we have seen this color palette: CM color, rainbow color, heat color, terrain color, like we have topo color. And there is one small topic pair. Okay, here we pass some parameters that you can go through this YouTube link. You will understand. Okay. Next topic is what? Bar plots. Already we have finished in our last class. Okay. Now, today's lab assignment is you need to practice the remaining three plots. What are the four plots? One is pie chart. Okay. Everything is written here. Use this, run and see the output and try to change the colors. Okay. If you observe here, he has used a rainbow color. Okay. Instead of rainbow, you can go with different palettes. Okay. Now you have to practice this pie chart completely. Then is histograms, then is density plots, third one, and fourth one is box plot. Okay, these four plots you need to practice now and upload the assignment in your Moodle. I already created an assignment in Moodle. This document also I have shared in Moodle. Document is shared in theory. Okay, theory part, and you need to upload the assignment in lab part. Okay, is it clear? If you are done, we are done with our module 3, because last class we have discussed what customization of plots, and we have done with what saving the plots. Everything we have finished. Now four plots you need to practice. Is it clear, ma? Yes. Okay, someone is asking mid exam dates. Mostly it will be in previous academic calendar when your module exam 4 is starting, the same dates will be there for your mid exam. Is it online or offline? Not sure, ma. Okay, we'll come to know. Any doubts in today's work?
No, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, shall I assign the breakout rooms or will you select your rooms?
We will select.
Okay, I'm creating 5 rooms. Okay, please select your rooms accordingly and join the breakout rooms and finish the work and upload it. Only you need to practice the 4 plots. join the breakout room fast.